Happy New Year and welcome back. OpenMW version 0.28.0 is now available for download. Have a look at the full changelog and you'll see that this is probably the largest release in OpenMW history. We made a ton of progress last year and we don't expect this year to be any different. So let's have a look at some of what's new in this release. Vertex morph animation support has been implemented. You can see this type of animation when looking at the thorax and antenna of the Quama Queen as they flail about, or at the bodies of Netch creatures as they regulate their air sacs or whatever it is that they do.
Yes,
this also paves the way for facial animations, which are a work in progress at the current moment.
There are a few ways we can do this, and the choice is yours. Very good.
As you can see, lip reading is out of the question for now.
Sign. And what would that be?
NPCs are now smart enough to save their torches for nighttime. Between you and me, Fargoth was the last one to catch on.
Dumbass.
Combat AI is now partially implemented for NPCs. Currently, only NPCs that are hostile by default are affected by this and will attack the player on sight. Those innocent people you've been hacking away at without consequence will have to wait until a future version to start defending themselves. Combat AI has also not yet fully been implemented for creatures, so for now, they will remain unresponsive to your attacks. They do at least seem to know that they are supposed to walk towards you. They just can't build up the courage to attack once they get there. It's kind of adorable. Or creepy, I'm really not sure. Vampirism is now implemented. Disease contraction is not implemented, so the player cannot actually catch the disease, porphyric hemophilia, that causes the condition from coming into contact with a vampire. Until this situation is resolved, you can use this urn in the debugging cell Todd test to give yourself the initial condition, if you want to try it out. Spellcasting and the accompanying visual effects have been implemented in this release. The player may now use self-targeted, touch-targeted, and ranged magic as they please. NPCs can technically cast spells as well, but the AI that would cause them to do so has not yet been implemented, so don't expect to see them doing so until at least the next release. Also, a metric f**k ton of magical effects were added in this release. I won't list them all, but about 70% of all vanilla magic has been implemented as of now. Additionally, many more effects are already done or close to being done and will be included in the next release. Enchanted items are now given a distinctive glow, just as in vanilla Morrowind. The player may now recharge their enchanted equipment using any soul gem that contains the trapped soul of some unfortunate creature that they met in their travels.
Delightful.
On the OpenCS side of things, a few more record tables have been implemented, but there's not much more to report at this time. Don't worry, we're still working on it and you'll see more of it in the future. But if you know C++ and the widget toolkit Qt, or I think you're supposed to pronounce it cute, we could definitely use more help, so come on down to the forums and introduce yourself. That's all for now. Leave your questions and comments below or on our official forums at openmw.org. Thanks for your support, and until next time, thanks for watching.
No! Oh, gods, no!